and congratulations. You're about to immerse yourself in the science of the Nutritarian Diet. The term Nutritarian means rich in nutrients and designed with the comprehensive features to maximally extend human lifespan. That's it. It's not designed to be the most acceptable or most popular. Rather, it's designed to be the most effective diet for maintaining youthfulness, excellent health, and prolonging lifespan. Modern advances in nutritional science have made it possible to avoid almost all heart attacks and strokes. But the most fascinating and impressive role of a Nutritarian diet is that it can ward off almost all cancers as well. That's right, we can prevent more than 90% of common non-smoking related cancers, such as breast, colon, and prostate cancer. And my work demonstrates exactly how to do this and the science that supports this claim. The standard American diet, often called the SAD, has left us in a sad state where it's normal to be overweight. It's normal to be sickly and in pain as we age and to develop high blood pressure, diabetes, memory loss, and heart disease. We don't just experience a premature death, but we also suffer for many years before dying. You've seen it. There's lots of sickness, discomfort, and invasive, uncomfortable, and futile medical procedures before the person actually dies. This does not have to happen. Sickness and disability is not a normal consequence of aging. When we eat a diet that is naturally rich in all the nutrients the human body thrives on, it offers powerful disease protection. It's normal to live a disease-free life and to maintain a normal weight your entire life. When you eat a diet that's naturally rich in all the nutrients, it's normal to live a life well into your later years and in excellent health with your full mental faculties intact and without pain. That is, of course, the whole point of the Nutritarian diet, a diet designed for excellent health, which allows you to enjoy life to the fullest. In this course, we'll examine the most critical concepts in longevity nutrition. The four fundamental principles that define the Nutritarian diet are nutrient density, comprehensive nutritional adequacy, hormone favorability, and avoiding toxins. We'll also study my unique contribution to nutritional science to better understand the physiology behind excess hunger and food cravings. The first principle, nutrient density, is defined by my health equation. Health equals nutrients divided by calories, or H equals N over C. That means your healthy life expectancy, the quality of your life in your later years, and how long you're going to live is proportional to the nutrient density of your diet throughout life. If you eat lots of foods that are rich in nutrients per calorie and consume lots of nutritional bang per caloric buck, you can earn great health. If you eat lots of foods that are low in nutrients and high in calories, junk foods, processed foods, white sugar and white flour and oils, calorie-rich, low-nutrient foods, you shorten your life accordingly. The second principle, comprehensive nutrient adequacy, or CNA, focuses on making sure that we have the full breadth of nutrients needed for maximal health. That means we need a variety of foods, and when our diet doesn't provide the optimal amount of certain nutrients, we may need to supply them through supplementation to assure adequacy. Supplements should be used conservatively and intelligently to make sure we obtain optimal levels of all nutrients needed, if not supplied adequately in our diet. Of course, this also considers the fact that certain supplemental ingredients can be harmful, especially when consumed in excess. Most Americans are damaging their health by taking potentially cancer-promoting supplemental ingredients, such as folic acid and vitamin A, which will be discussed in detail. The third principle of a Nutritarian diet is to make sure our diet is hormonally favorable. We want to avoid too much of certain hormones that can increase the risk of cancer, increase the risk of diabetes, and increase the risk of dementia. The two hormones we will specifically consider are insulin and IGF-1. Excess production of insulin and excess production of IGF-1 can promote both cardiovascular disease and cancer. The fourth and last principle of the Nutritarian diet is to avoid toxins. Of course, it would make sense that we would want to avoid consuming chemicals, carcinogens, and infectious agents. Optimizing our nutrient intake is obviously not enough if we choose to bombard our bodies with toxic substances. You will learn what to look out for and what to stay away from. Lastly, we'll cover toxic hunger and food addiction. We'll go over the physical cravings that cause overeating and the psychological factors that play a role and how to overcome them. I hope the knowledge that you walk away with encourages you to take excellent care of your own health and pass the gift on to others. Good luck with your studies, and I'm looking forward to hearing from you and how you and your loved ones and acquaintances benefit from your expanding expertise in the subject.